Hello guys, welcome to Physics Grad. This is the second video on change of variables in integrals, and in this video we are going to see what is the formula for changing the variables from one set to the another set when we have the case of multiple integrals. More specifically, I am going to prove for the case of double integrals here, and the generalization to multiple integrals is intuitively straightforward. So we are just going to see for double integrals, and that should hopefully give you an intuition as to how the formula holds for higher integrals as well. So we start by noticing the fact that, or we start by stating what we already know, which is we know that in case of single variable change, which we had seen in part 1 of this video, the formula for change of variables for the integral of this form was given by the following. And this is what we had seen in the case of change of variables when the function was dependent on only one variable. Okay. Now, in this video, we are going to consider multiple integrals, more specifically double integrals, and we are going to see what is the formula to be used in that case. Okay, so for this, I state the following theorem and prove it. And what the theorem says is the following. Integral over the region xy. Now, I am going to explain what each of these symbols mean soon. So please be patient until the end. So double integral over the region Rxy of some function f of xy with respect to dx dy is given by plus or minus integral Ruv, where we change the variables from xy to uv of the function f when, but now it is expressed as x is expressed as f of uv and y is expressed as g of uv. And of course, the integration is with respect to du dv. But we are going to put the determinant of the Jacobian here. Okay. So uv du dv. So this guy is nothing but determinant of Jacobian matrix. Now in this case, the Jacobian matrix will be dou x by dou u, dou x by dou v and dou y by dou v. Okay. So the determinant of this will be dou x by dou u times dou y by dou v minus dou x by dou v times. So basically we multiply these two and multiply these two and subtract them. Okay. So that is how you take the determinant, and we are going to prove this. Okay. So before we prove this, we have to say or state when this particular theorem is valid. Okay. So I'm going to call this as equation one. So this is valid under the following assumptions. So the assumptions are as follows. Rxy and Ruv are bounded closed regions in the xy and uv planes and bounded by smooth simple closed curves C CXY and CUV respectively. So if you have referred to my previous maths lectures, you will know what the meaning of smooth, simple, closed curve is, and I'm not going to repeat it again. So you can just refer to the previous videos, and if you know already, that's good. So secondly, the function f of xy is defined and has continuous first derivatives in a circular domain. I'm going to explain what all these things are diagrammatically also, so that it becomes clear. Circular domain dxy containing rxy. C, x as a function of uv, f of uv, and y is equal to g of uv are also obviously defined and have continuous second derivative, and second derivative in domain duv, including the, so the ruv is inside duv, that is what it means, duv including ruv. And when the point uv is in duv, then xy is in dxy, okay, so which are the respective domains. Point D, when uv is on the curve CUV, the point xy with x equal to f of uv and y equal to g of uv is going to be on CXY, the corresponding curve enclosing RXY, and as UV traces CUV once in positive direction, that is anticlockwise direction by convention, then XY traces CXY once in positive or negative direction in accordance with, accordingly we use this plus or minus sign. So if this is a plus sign, that means the xy point also traces in counterclockwise direction, whereas if you choose the minus sign, it traces in the other direction according to the plus minus sign. Okay, now let us represent these things diagrammatically and understand what they mean. So if you have our xy plane and this is our circular domain dxy, and this is going to be our region under consideration rxy bounded by the curve cxy, okay, and let O be the center of the domain dxy. Similarly, we have our uv plane, and here we can again, corresponding to the domain dxy, we have the domain duv, and inside this we have the region ruv with the curve cuv. Okay, and what we are saying is that as the points on the curve traverses the curve anti-clockwise, correspondingly the points on the curve CXY will also traverse it either anticlockwise or clockwise, depending on whether we use plus or minus sign in the equation. Okay, all right. Now note that the mapping from UV plane to XY plane need not be 1-1. So just like how we saw in part 1, this is, so the analogous case for one dimension is given in part 1 of this video. which is I think 3 or 4 lectures below in the playlist. So if you have understood that, this is just the two-dimensional analog of the same thing. So the mapping from UV plane to XY plane need not be 1-1 except on the boundary. Except on boundary. What is this boundary? This boundary corresponds to the curve CUV and CXY. There the function mapping should be 1-1. But in other case, other places, for example, this point can be mapped to a point outside RXY like this. Okay. So there is no restriction on that. Also, this implies that when UV is on RUV, corresponding XY need not be in RXY. This is what I just showed. So now we are going to prove this. Okay. And to prove this, first of all, we are going to write our function. So we can write the function f of xy as a partial derivative of some other function with respect to x. Okay. So corresponding to f, we can define some function q such that dou q by dou x is equal to f of xy. And here we can assume that q has continuous first derivatives. Only then we can define this. Okay. So this implies that the q can be given as integral from some point x naught. We can choose any x naught here to the final point x of the function f of t y dt. Okay. So when I differentiate this on both sides, this is what I'm going to get. So this is writing it in differential form and this is writing it in integral form. Okay. So here we can choose x naught y naught as the center of the domain dxy. Okay. Now we use the Green's theorem. Now we use Green's theorem, which again I have proved in the previous lecture. So what does this Green's theorem say? So a closed line integral along a curve P, a curve C of the following quantity P dx plus Q dy, where P and Q are functions of X and Y, can be written as a double integral over the region R bounded by the curve C times of dou Q by dou X minus dou P by dou Y dx dy. And when we proved this, we had proved them by taking these things individually, where we saw that integral over the curve C Q dy was equal to double integral over R dou Q by dou X dx dy. Okay. So this is how we proved it. We proved this separately for this guy and separately for this guy, and we subtracted the two to get these. Okay. And we are going to use this particular relation for our proof. So that is what we are going to do now. So we'll just remember this relation. Okay. So we'll get back to that when we need it. Okay. So this implies that our integral Rxy f of xy dx dy can be written as integral over the region Rxy dou q by dou x dx dy. Now I'm going to use this relation, integral over R dou q by dou x dx dy should be equal to this kind of a quantity. So applying this formula here, this should be equal to integral Cxy q dy. Okay. But q should again be a function of x and y. So this implies that integral Cxy q of x y dy can be written as, when I map it to the uv plane, I can write it. So basically I'm using u and v as a parameter to represent the curve cxy. So if I do that, this will be q of f of uv comma g of uv dg. Okay, because y is g, x is f. And this plus corresponds to the case when we take our convention such that as we traverse x in counterclockwise, we traverse cuv counterclockwise also. And negative sign when we do the opposite. Okay, that is, when we traverse clockwise in cuv, the corresponding traversion in x cxy will be anticlockwise. So that is what these signs will represent. Okay. Fine. So let us continue. Now this can be written as plus or minus integral over c uv q of f of uv g of uv, and since g depends on u and v, this dg can be written as dou g by dou u du plus dou g by dou v dv. Okay. So first let us consider the positive sign and prove the relation. So the RHS is of the form integral CUV P1 DU plus Q1 DV, where P1 is equal to Q times dou G by dou U and Q1 equal to Q times dou G by dou V. Okay, so Q multiplied by these guys gives P1 and Q multiplied by this guy gives Q1. Okay, so here of course again P1 and Q1 are defined in DUV and have continuous derivatives. Okay, so now we again apply Green's theorem, where we use this formula. So we use this formula now. Here P1 is P, Q1 is Q, X is U, Y is V. So if we use this relation and we write it in this form, what will we get? So this will become equal to RHS. If we take the only the positive sign, this will become equal to the integral over the region RUV dou Q1 by dou U minus dou P1 by dou V DU DV. Okay. Now this can be written as integral RUV dou Q by dou U. So Q1 is Q times, oh sorry, I have written it the other way, I think. No, this is correct. So Q1 is Q times dou G dou V. So dou Q1 by dou U is going to be dou by dou U of Q times dou G by dou V. So applying the product rule, this will be dou Q by dou U dou G by dou V plus Q times dou square G by dou V dou U. Okay. So similarly, we apply the product rule for all the quantities here. And what we get is, so dou Q1 by dou U is going to become dou Q by dou U dou G by dou V plus Q dou square G by dou U dou V. And again, applying the product rule for this quantity, we get dou Q by dou V dou G by dou U plus dou square G So q times dou square g dou u dou v. And finally we have du dv. Now this quantity will get cancelled with this. So what remains is these two terms. So this becomes equal to integral ruv. Now this q is going to be a function of x and y. So I can write it as dou q by dou x times dou x by dou u plus dou q by dou y times dou y by dou u into dou g by dou v. So this is this term minus dou q by dou x by dou v plus dou q by dou y by dou v times dou g by dou u. This multiplied by du dv. Okay. But now we use the fact that our x is nothing but f and y is g. So if we use that, this becomes ruv dou q by dou x dou f by dou u plus dou q by dou y dou g by dou u times dou g by dou v minus dou q by dou x dou f by dou v plus dou q by dou y dou g by dou v times dou g by dou u du dv. So now if you notice, this term minus this term will cancel each other, and what will remain is these two terms multiplied by the corresponding these quantities. So we get ruv dou q by dou x, if I take common, this is common in both, times dou f by dou u dou g by dou v minus dou f by dou v dou g by dou u times du dv. But this is nothing but the determinant of the matrix or the Jacobian matrix as defined earlier. Where did we define it? Yeah. So determinant of this matrix, if we write x as f and y as g, what you are going to get is the same thing. So this can be written as integral ruv dou q by dou x dou f g by dou uv. This is how we represent a Jacobian determinant, okay, times du dv. But our dou q by dou x was nothing but our f. So our f of xy was nothing but dou q by dou x, that is what we wrote. So this is equal to integral ruv f of uv g of uv times dou f g by dou uv du dv. So this is for the positive sign, and similarly we can prove for the negative sign. So therefore finally we end up with the formula rxy f of xy dx dy is equal to plus or minus integral ruv f of uv g of uv times the Jacobian determinant du dv. Okay. So when we are not concerned about whether the corresponding tracing of the curve is in the same direction in the mapping or not, we simply take the modulus of this quantity, or we simply write it as, so if we don't care about direction of traversal of cxy and cuv, then we can simply write rxy, this quantity is equal to the positive of this quantity f times mod dou fg by dou uv. du dv. Okay, we can write it in this form. Okay, in fact, these two forms are the same. So depending on whether this gives you the negative value or positive value, you will get this plus or minus sign. Okay. All right. So this is what I wanted to prove, and this can be generalized for integrals having more than, or when you consider integration along more than two variables, same formula will hold, but instead of having a 2 cross 2 Jacobian matrix determinant here, you will have n cross n Jacobian matrix there. Okay, so that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. See you next time.